So I'm just going to record this quickly because I've got two videos to record today because I'm going to be busy tomorrow. So let's get this done. Right, so I was in the shower and I was thinking, what if Microsoft sold Rareware to Nintendo? Now, obviously this will probably never ever happen, because Rareware has the copyright to a lot of Nintendo's most famous game franchise, such as Donkey Kong Country series, Diddy Kong Racing, Conker's Bad Fur Day, Banjo-Kazooie, and Donkey Kong 64. You know, they have the copyright to all those games. So if Microsoft were to sell Rareware to Nintendo, that would mean that they could make sequels or remakes of those games quite easily. Which, if they did do that, that would mean big bad news for Microsoft, because, you know, a HD remake of Donkey Kong Country or DK64 on the Switch, that would probably sell like hotcakes. Or Banjo-Kazooie or Banjo-Tooie, or even a Banjo-3E, they would just sell like nothing else. And Nintendo is pretty much the king of platformers, so I doubt that a joint effort between Nintendo and Rareware to make Banjo-3E would go down badly. Like, that would probably never happen. So, but let's say the entire management of Microsoft was like on all of the drugs and went hyper consumer friendly and decided that it would be more consumer friendly to sell Rareware to Nintendo, and they were just like, well, Rareware isn't really making any console selling games with us, but with Nintendo, Nintendo will pay a lot of money to have them because they could make console selling games with the Donkey Kong franchise and all that. So they sell it to Nintendo. Well, then it will probably take a while and a lot of money from Nintendo. Like, I doubt, no matter how many drugs Microsoft would be on, that they would sell Rareware cheaply to Nintendo. They'd probably sell it for like $1 billion or something like that. Just like some silly amount of money. Like, probably more money than I'm ever going to see in my lifetime. So, that happens. Nintendo now owns Rareware. The first thing I think they would or should do is like port Rare Replay onto the Switch in some shape or form. That would, to test the waters, to see if there is really a market for Banjo-Kazooie sequels, or Conker's Bad Fur Day sequel, or Donkey Kong Country sequels. They could even add Donkey Kong Country games into the Rare Replay mix, see if there's a market for that out there. And let's be honest, it would probably sell quite well. Rare Replay, that would sell a lot of copies. So then, Nintendo's just like, okay, we've got Rareware. We've established that there's a big market for Rare games, with Rare Replay selling well. The first thing I think they should do is make a Banjo-3E, and maybe start a Banjo-Kazooie spin-off series, from Nuts and Bolts, and just make it so that Nuts and Bolts isn't in the official timeline, and just like remake it somewhat, and just make it so like it's a spin-off, and then just make a spin-off like side franchise of Banjo-Kazooie Nuts and Bolts, because a bit like Diddy Kong Racing, because that was actually quite a bit of fun. And if it wasn't tied to Banjo-Kazooie, it would probably have gone down a lot better with consumers. But then make Banjo-3 and then just see where they go from Banjo-3 and maybe 4E and 5E or however many E's they want to put on the end of numbers. They have got episodes coming out, so yeah, that's another reason why I definitely don't think Microsoft would sell Rare at this point, because they're releasing a HD port of Battletoads, so unless they want to get out, and then it doesn't do well or something like that, and they just sell it to Nintendo to try and recuperate some of those losses. I could see that happening, maybe. Yeah, it's Battletoads, so. Obviously, they'd probably remake the Donkey Kong Country games, or even make a new sequel to them. Even featuring like some new characters, and they definitely either remake or make a sequel to Diddy Kong Racing. Maybe a new Viva Pinata game. I don't think Rare still hold the rights to make a Viva Pinata game. I doubt it. There was a Viva Pinata game on the DS. Some facts there. But yeah, if Rare did get sold to Nintendo, or some way found their way onto the Switch, I definitely think they would just sell so much. They would just make so much money on the Switch, because here's the difference between the Xbox and the Switch. The Switch is generally, main audience, younger, more young audience, or hardcore, Nintendo fans, or just regular Nintendo fans. So a big chunk of Nintendo's history is platformers, so obviously the Banjo-Kazooie franchise and Conker's Bad Fur Day would do well on the Nintendo Switch. So we have that. Oh, even maybe a Star Fox Adventure sequel. No, I don't think they'd ever do that. So we would have, they would sell quite well on the Switch, which is why either I would say it would be in Microsoft's best intentions to either have Rareware start developing games for the Switch, or just sell them to Nintendo. Because honestly, Rareware right now, they're making good games, right? They're making alright games, but they're not Rareware of the past. They're not the Rareware who made Banjo-Kazooie. They're not the Rareware that made Banjo-Kazooie. They're not the Rareware that made Conker's Bad Fur Day. That Rareware sold consoles. This Rareware sells games. If you don't know what I mean by selling consoles and selling games, a console seller is usually like a third party or a franchise that makes really good games, and people will just buy a console just to play their games. That's why examples of these games: Smash Bros, Mario games in general, Pokemon, even Halo used to be that, and Battlefield, games that would make you want to buy a console just to play those games. And that's what Rare used to be like. You would buy a console just to play Banjo-Kazooie or Banjo-Kooie or Conker's Bad Fur Day. But you can't really say that about the games they make today. There's only one game they've made recently that made me want to get an Xbox One, and that was Rare Replay, because it had all of their past games and it was a bit tricky to get. Banjo-Kooie, Conker's Bad Fur Day. They're a little bit expensive. They're about £50. Which for that I could get a brand new Switch game if I really wanted. So the past games haven't even gone down in value even. So but honestly, heck, even the Donkey Kong Country franchise was a console seller, you could say. They aren't making just the level of quality games they used to make. You can go on all day about how good that pirate game they recently made is. But here's the thing: at the end of the day, it's only a good game. Like, I'm not gonna buy an Xbox One for an alright game. Like, you know, it's not a great game, it's not a console seller, it's a game seller. Like, they become a game seller. They don't make games that sell consoles, they make games that sell themselves. Like, yeah, well, hardly even that. They're just alright games, they're not even above average games, they're just average games. They make games that they can sell, they don't make games that sell consoles anymore. If you get what I'm saying here. And I do think if they, you know, if they got sold over to Nintendo, or Nintendo bought them out, then I do think they could become the console selling company they used to be. This is nothing against Microsoft here. Like, Microsoft, they're alright. They make some good games, and some bad decisions. I do like what they're doing with Minecraft, and, you know, they are very consumer friendly, which is something they currently have over Sony and Nintendo at the minute. Pardon me. Anyway. But the thing is, they have their own style, and that's usually first-person shooters. Like, you go to Microsoft for first-person shooters, you go to Sony for open-world, massive games, you know, just giant, massive open-world games. You go to Nintendo for a good time, with just, like, fun games. Like, they may be weird, but they're fun. Like, even the Where's Mario game, in my opinion, Sunshine, that's still a fun game to play. That's why you go to Nintendo. But you don't go to Microsoft to play platformers. You don't go to them to play card building games. You don't go to them to play Battletoads. You go to them for first-person shooter games. And that's why I just feel like Rareware would have a more profitable home on the Nintendo Switch with Nintendo. Because you do go to Nintendo is a company you go to for games like Banjo-Kazooie, and Conker's Bad Fair Day, and Battletoads. Like, come on. It's just like, it's like mixing curry and cotton candy. Microsoft and Rareware. Microsoft is the koi, Rareware is candy. Cotton candy. Cotton candy is sweet and delicious and nice. The koi is spicy, hot, and extreme. They just don't mix. Square peg and a round hole. Which is why when I hear that Microsoft bought Rareware, I was just like, really? What is their plan here? Like, the Rareware fans will still be staying with Nintendo because they still make platformers and the kind of games that Rareware was making at that time. And the Microsoft fans won't really bother with Rareware because they don't make the kind of games they typically like. And Rareware fans will still be staying with Nintendo because Nintendo fans and Rareware fans will still be staying on Nintendo, so what do they get out of this? Are they like, don't you make a Banjo-Kazooie spin-off first-person shooter? No, they made a Banjo-Kazooie car racer, but it's just like, those companies do not mix. It would mix as well as if they like bought Pokemon. Like, square peg, round hole. Like, nothing against Microsoft. Excellent company. They do some good stuff. But they just don't know how to use Rareware. Like, Rareware is a hammer. Well, no. Rareware is a screwdriver. But all that Microsoft really knows how to use is a hammer. Where Nintendo is well adept to using screwdrivers. Like, And even the people who work at Rareware basically agree with me, because they left Rareware and they made their place Honic, which if they got bought out by Nintendo, the internet would probably go on fire. Especially if they were collabing with Rareware to make a new Banjo-Kazooie game. Anyway, you know, and they basically made their own Banjo-Kazooie game in Ukulele. You know, even the people who work at Microsoft are just like, yeah, they just don't know how to use us, so we're going to go and use ourselves. Like, yeah, they just, right. Again, brilliant company, made some fantastic games. It's just this combination that does not work well. Anyway, I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.